Hello, everybody. This is Dr. Bob and Dr. Kason DeMaria, and we are excited tonight on our Facebook Live, and we want this to go around the world because we're going to talk about a very special subject. We're going to talk about
breast thermography, and I can share this is one of the most important things that you can do for prevention. And I know that if you're out there watching us, give us a little wave, because I know that specifically all you women out there, this is something that's going to be a different approach for you, and it's non-invasive, and there's no compression,
no slapping,
no compression, and no radiation. This is huge, and so many ladies, they're out there looking for a different approach, Dr. Bob, but they do not know what to do.
You know, we had someone that came in today. They said they are tired of getting radiation on their breasts. We had one person had it done 22 times, and she wondered if that was the reason, all kidding aside, why she may have had breast cancer. Also very serious, we have someone that is in our life right now that's going to be going through having her breast removed, and that's one of the reasons that we started doing the breast thermography, because we've been doing the breast thermography in our practice now for over 4 years, and we had ladies that were asking us because they really trust us. And you know, I wrote Dr. Bob's Drugless Guide to Balancing Female Hormones, and we talk about estrogen, and they wanted a different approach. And so Dr. Kason and Debbie are certified to do the breast thermography. So why don't you go into a little bit of detail what breast thermography is, Dr. Kason?
So in the breast, what's really exciting, we were talking about no radiation and no compression. So breast thermography, it's a different approach to health. And what we do, and we're certified to do this, we do 6 different images and pictures overall of the breast tissue. And what you do, there's different positions that you're sitting in, and it's all through temperature. So why that's really important is because thermography, it shows us physiology or function in the body, which is 8 to 10 years ahead of a mammogram. And what's really interesting about the cells and the tissues, we have a little chart here.
We'll make sure we can post that.
We can post this for you so that way you can see it. But on here, you can see on this, so at 256 cells here, what it is you can go ahead and see that at 256 cells, something can be seen on a thermography. And on a mammogram, way down here, you can see on the chart that at 4 billion cells, something will show up on a mammogram at 1 centimeter. So 1 centimeter, very small, that's when it starts to actually show up in a mammogram. And you can imagine how many ladies out there that you've had several mammograms done and they're all showing normal, but you actually could have lymphatic congestion or other things going on, which is a start of some type of, it could be a possible disease.
Pathology, I know it's really is very fascinating what we've learned, very simply put. There's so many things about physiology. It's very common. One of the 2 or 3 areas that we notice with the breast thermography is we're looking at patterns. We're not diagnosing. There's a team of medical doctors that review this. They send us the information. And very commonly, we'll see a pattern that suggests breast cyst. Now, because of our experience, we know that breast cyst will respond to local application of clear iodine. We also know that a woman who has a low thyroid has a greater chance to have breast cysts because of the iodine. But I think, Dr. Kason, which we see so many times, is that the liver is compromised, it's congested. The typical pattern we see is a lady with 2 children. After baby number 2, the liver itself is compromised. So your breasts drain into your armpits, which go into your liver. So the lymphatic system becomes congested. And I'm going to make a very interesting statement right now. The Western medical community has everybody believing that the cancer spreads to the lymphatic system. I would like you to understand the physiology is that lymphatic system is so compromised that it cannot handle the cancer cells fast enough to dump them into the liver because the liver is compromised. So a part of the pattern that we see on the thermography is we see lymph congestion in the armpit area. And I want you to know that we can duplicable do this, we could replicate this, that we can help improve lymphatic flow, which means the breast can drain into the lymph system, which drains into the liver. That was a huge for us, and we've been doing it constantly now for over 4 years.
And what's really exciting is anyone can do this as early as being 20 years old. And the reason why you want to start on this preventative pattern is you do one scan initially and then you do another one in 3 months, which establishes your normal baseline. So your breast tissue, which is really amazing when we're learning all this, it's like a thumbprint. So your breast is different than your mom's, your grandma, a sister, a cousin. Everyone's unique. So what could be normal for your overall physiology could be your normal variant, and that's why it's so important that you do one initially and then one in 3 months. And then after that, women are choosing annually to do this for prevention. But it's safe because there's no radiation and there's no compression and you're not causing any kind of irritation. And research shows that after a period of time of radiation, that can cause cancer. And we've seen that in our practice so many times. And you know, we don't have time to go about the multi-billion dollar cancer industry and into all that, but so many women now are asking, why isn't my healthcare provider sharing this with me? And with that, we're sharing it with you now that you can take action, and all you need to do is email us, you can call our office. I know, you know, we're here to help make a difference for you and to help your family.
You know, it's kind of interesting because all these thoughts are going through my mind right now. Augmentation. We have a lot of ladies today that have had breast augmentation. You can still have the thermography because sometimes we'll see that your augmentation may have moved. Maybe you had your breast taken off, but we're still looking for that lymph congestion in your armpit area. Just because they took your breast off doesn't mean your physiology is normal. And it can be any age. I had a lady that was 73 years old and she was doing some hormone replacement therapy. And she had what we call hot red breasts. It was because of the estrogen. And we've seen how stress can impact the function of the breast. So the breast health itself is a big puzzle. And I like to think of us as puzzle solvers.
And dense breast tissue. This is really common. Right. So if you've had a mammogram and they're saying that you have dense breast tissue, so many times, just a quick story, we have ladies come into our office, they've had a mammogram done. I've heard this so many times at 5 o'clock on a Friday, they get the letter and the letter says, something came up on your mammogram that's abnormal, come back so we can do some further investigation. And then they do a biopsy of that. And then guess what they tell them? You're normal, but I want you to come back in 6 months.
So we're gonna encourage you. We don't tell people not to do a mammogram. If you wanna do them, that's fine. But we encourage thermography, any age. Come and pay us a visit. You can come to see us from anywhere in the world. And after we do the thermography and the radiologists read them, we will actually sit down one-on-one and create a protocol of wellness. We so much appreciate you passing this information on. It truly is a matter of life and death. I'm Dr. Bob and Dr. Casey DeMaria.